Welcome to this FlightGear tutorial, in which we will be taking a look at GPS and the route manager. One of the questions I get most is, how do you know where the airport is? Well, let's say I want to fly from Amsterdam Schiphol to, let's say, Frankfurt Airport, because we've never done that before. The most simple method would be to open the GPS settings, select airport from this list, and fill in the ICAO code of Frankfurt, which is EDDF. If I then look at this side of the window, I'll find some info about Frankfurt Airport, including the heading I should turn to fly directly to the airport. I could then fill in that heading in my autopilot, along with some altitude stuff, and enable the whole thing, and then just sit back and enjoy my cup of coffee. But that only brings me to the center of the airport, and not to any place to start a nice approach to a runway. This is where the route manager jumps in, as well as our good old friend, the multiplayer map. Let's visit the multiplayer map and find EDDF, as if we would want to find an ILS frequency. Find your way to the start of the glide slope, and then click this icon. After some thinking, the map should show more info than just the ILS stuff. You can use these specific points as waypoints to guide your plane to the beginning of the glide slope. So write these things down somewhere and go back to FlightGear. Now open the route manager. First of all, fill in your destination airport and runway. If you would now fill in a waypoint in this input box and click on add, it would just append the waypoint to the list. But we want it to be in between Schiphol and Frankfurt. To do this, select the waypoint above the place where you want to insert your new waypoint by clicking on it. Then fill in the waypoint information in the box below and click on add. But that's not all you can do with waypoints. You can also attach specific altitude information. For example, I want to cross FRD 69 at 3000 feet. To do this, just type in FRD 69 first, and then type at 3000. Now, in order for your plane to fly the route, you still have to activate the route manager. To do this, simply click activate. This arrow here indicates which waypoint the plane is flying to right now. Sometimes, when you activate the route manager, it makes the plane fly back to the departure airport, like it's doing now. If this is the case, just select the waypoint you actually want to fly to first, and click on jump to. Now all you need to do is make yourself another cup of coffee and wait for another 24 minutes. Thanks for watching this tutorial. Be sure to tell me if this helped you at all by leaving a comment below. And as always, I hope to see you back next time for the next episode of FlightGear HowTo.